One of the most important things in achieving web accessibility is using semantic HTML. And what that means is using the appropriate elements around the content you'd like to display. Right now we have a button and we're using the button element, and it is behaving as a button should, and it is using the browser styles and the browser effects. So right now if I click on it, you know, it has the button effect, and if I focus it using the tab, it gets focused, and if I press the interval, it gets clicked. If I press enter, sometimes they get activated when you press enter, sometimes they don't. But when you press interval, it gets clicked or tapped. And that's why it's important to use the appropriate HTML element, because they have a lot of stuff built into it that makes accessibility very easy and actually makes the website usable by a person who uses screen reader or who is navigating using the tab key. Another thing that's very important is using the H1 and H2 and the rest of the heading elements in the correct order. So H1 should appear as the first element on the page. H1 should appear first, and then H2 should appear afterwards, and H3, H4, H5, and H6. A lot of people make the mistake of using the header element to style. For example, they have something like this. They have a paragraph, and they want to make, for example, this text right here stand out. So what they do is they use a heading element, and this is very bad for accessibility. Why? First of all, some users who are using screen readers, they like to navigate the website using the headings, okay? So whenever they land on the website, they can have their screen reader create like a list of the headings, and they can navigate through them. It also helps them navigate through articles, and it's basically, it's the correct way of doing things. For example, you wouldn't be reading a book and then suddenly to have the same font used as the name of the chapter used in the middle of your page. That would be crazy. But if you want to, for example, if you want to make this word stand out, you can use strong, or you can use CSS if you want, you can apply the same styles the heading have using just a div and some CSS, but don't use the headings elements or any element where it's not appropriate. Another element that is very often misused is the anchor element that is used as a button. Now, I especially see it when it's used for the hamburger menu toggle. Now, this is so bad because if you remove the href attribute on the anchor link, the link, the anchor, becomes nothing. Okay, it is as if you are using a div element, since the href defines the anchor as a link, since the href makes the anchor actually point to a different document. So whenever the screen readers see this, they're just going to, if you don't even put a menu, they're just going to say menu. But if you're just using the menu icon or the hamburger icon, which I see a lot of people do and which I used to do, and that's really horrible and you shouldn't do it, then the screen reader is not going to announce it at all, if you're lucky, or it's going to garble something, so people won't be able to understand that this is actually a menu toggle, and menu is one of the most important things in a website. So instead of using an anchor for the hamburger, for any other button, use the button element, okay? Don't use the anchor element, because it is very unsemantic. So the other thing that's very unsemantic, and it used to be very popular in the past, is coding custom form controls. For example, a custom dropdown, a custom checkbox, a custom radio button. Now, in the past, it used to be very popular, and like every second designer was, sketching up custom forms in Photoshop. But this is something you should never do, because first of all, nobody cares how your form looks like, okay? Everybody hates filling in forms online, and making them pretty is not going to make the experience any easier. What you can do to enhance forms online is to have them accessible and to have a kick-ass user experience. But making them pretty or changing the color or the focus styles is not going to make a difference. And if you have something like a div class drop-down, option one, option two, for example, here I have a select drop-down, you know, so much of the accessibility is gone, because form controls are really cool because they have accessibility built into them, and they respond to keyboard access, they respond very well to screen reader, I can use interval and enter to navigate a form, and I can use tab to go through the field forms. But people want to style them, so they must remove, for example, here I had to remove the select, which is the normal drop down for a form, and I'm using a div, and this is really inaccessible and you should never do that. Going back to our previous example, now you must be thinking, okay, Stefany, but what if I'm forced to use an unsemantic element? What if my project manager says all of our hamburgers needs to be within the anchor element? Well, in that case, if you absolutely have to, what you gotta do is you have to make the element behave as it is a different element. Let me show you. Here I have the anchor with my hamburger button. Now, if I want to make it sound like a button, so for example, right now, if a screen reader tries to read the hamburger, it will just either not say anything or just say some noises for some reason. But if, how can I make it when the screen reader reads the hamburger right now, it will say button. So to do that, use the row attribute and use the value of button. And this will make the anchor behave as if it is a button element. This is why row is an excellent attribute, because it makes you make unsemantic elements into semantic ones, like the ones you want them to be. And don't forget, the next attribute you want to add is tab index 0. Now, what that's going to do is it's going to make the element focusable. Okay, so right now I have selected the area where my site is, and if I press tab, see, right now when I press tab, our hamburger is outlined, and this is really good for accessibility. It's behaving as if it is a button because we use the row button and the tab index 0. So always make sure to add tab index 0 and the row, whatever row you want to convert it to. And you can also use this if you want to make divs into buttons or spans into buttons as well. So semantics, very important. Please read on it. And I know it can be very difficult, but if you are ever hesitating which element to use, what I suggest to do is go on Stack Overflow, go to a development forum, or if you have an accessibility guru friend, ask them what kind of element to use. And the people on the forums and your friends will be very happy to answer. This is what I do, and it's been really good for the websites and for me.